We're always concerned when the data is going up, either from cases or from hospitalizations. Where we go from here is a difficult question to answer. As we've said before, hospitalizations are a lagging metric, so it's the end result of viral transmission that's occurred in the community. So if we can interrupt transmission or lower transmission in the community, then the result we'll see will be the hospitalizations will go down. It's difficult to forecast now, though, which direction we're going to go. But it also takes time to turn those curves. So if you think about transmission occurs in the community, so people are becoming infected. Some will become sick and come to the hospital. And as we've seen from our shelter in place orders and other things that we've put in place to decrease transmission, it usually takes a couple of weeks before we see the impact of those interventions. And so if those cases continue to rise, we probably won't see an impact for a couple of weeks with the mask wearing.
The 7-day average number of new cases in the St. Louis area has jumped significantly, hitting its highest point since early May. How will these case numbers impact hospitalizations in the future? And what scenario are area hospitals preparing for?
Well, certainly anytime you have increased cases in the community, that really reflects that there's increased transmission. And from the numbers that we've been looking at, it is concerning. And so anytime you see increased number of cases, increased transmission, the result is going to be eventually you're going to see an increase in hospitalizations. So the key is then to keep that as low as we can. Now we're able to handle the COVID patients that we have right now. We've certainly handled much more, as everybody has seen earlier in the spring. But really, we don't want to get back up to that level. So hospitals have learned a lot since the beginning of this pandemic on how to treat patients and how to organize the care, how to properly protect employees and staff and other patients. And so I feel like the healthcare systems are well prepared to deal with an increase in COVID patients. But really the key is to just to not get there, to not need to do those things. And that's why we need to be doing some of these simple and effective measures like mask wearing and social distancing and hand washing.
Thank you.